الحمد لله الذي هدى، والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، خصوصا على سيد الرسل وخاتم الأنبياء وعلى آله وأصحابه الذين اجتبى. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تخونوا الله والرسول وتخونوا أماناتكم وأنتم تعلمون، واعلموا أنما أموالكم وأولادكم فتنة وأن الله عنده أجر عظيم. صدق الله العظيم. الله سبحانه وتعالى made a rule in this life, and that is, every action of human being has an effect on him and on people around him. Whatever a person does not just fly in the air. It stays with this person. The effect of these deeds, they stay with us. And depending on what type of deed that is, the effect could be very long lasting. And just as our children inherit a lot of things from us, they may get the effect of those a'mal and those sins also. This is the rule of this life, that every action has a reaction. A'mal have their effect. If a person would do wrong to someone and would keep on oppressing the person until he kills that person, and if he thinks that now everything have died, everything is gone, the person that I was oppressing, my enemy, my opponent is gone, he's dead, so my zulm is dead. No. His zulm is not dead. In fact, now is the real thing that will come up. Now if this person thinks that I will live with peace of mind, I'm going to have my peace of mind after I have killed my opponent and the people that I did not like, and I made those people cry, starve to death, and their children will cry for the rest of their lives, and I will live in peace, that's not happening. The effect of his amal, the effect of his deed, his oppression, his wrongdoings, his sins, will stay with him in this life and in the hereafter. This effect is not going to leave him. Is not going to leave him here, will not leave him in his grave, will not leave him in Akhirah. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس ليذيقهم بعض الذي عملوا لعلهم يرجعون. Mischief have appeared in the land and in the ocean. Corruption have appeared in the land and in the water. بما كسبت أيدي الناس, because of the deeds of people, because of the actions of human beings. لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا, so that Allah will make them taste the effect of some of their a'mal. This is so that we get the taste of the effect of some of our a'mal. So we realize that what would happen on the day when the effect of all of my a'mal will come up. If this is the effect of two or three of my deeds that I have done in the past, whereas in reality I have done hundreds and maybe thousands, so what would be my situation the day when I would see the effect of all of my deeds in my qabr and on the day of qiyamah? لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا. This is only to make them taste some of what they have done. بعض. Some of what they have done. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Hoping that they would stop doing all the wrongdoings that they have been doing. That's the hope. The effect that has been that is being seen in this life is not to punish. Is لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So that we step back. We stop. We realize that this is the effect of it. We need to remember that every sin, every disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything that displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has that effect on our life and it's really hurting us and hurting people around us. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, إِنَّ الْعَبْدْ لَيُحْرَمُ الرِّزْقِ بِالذَّنْبِ يُصِيبُهُ. Sometime a person gets deprived of the rizq because of his sins. Allah closes the doors of rizq for him because of his disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had opened the doors of some halal rizq for him, for his family, so that he can take some halal earning to his home. All of a sudden he started misusing his wealth, misusing his abilities, misusing the strength and the energy he's getting from that money, from that food. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala closes the door of that halal for him. Now go and struggle. And maybe the person will end up bringing haram into his house now. All of this haram that he's bringing and is feeding his children, and the children are being nourished with haram, is not because the doors of halal were closed for him. It's only because he disobeyed Allah and he closed that door on himself. Now, not only that he's being affected, even his children are being affected, that they're eating haram too. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Quran very clearly that in the previous nations, we closed the doors of halal rizq for them. And we told them, the only way you will get it is if you stop doing what you have been doing and repent to Allah, turn to Allah, seek Allah's forgiveness. فَقُلْتِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. Seek forgiveness of your Lord, because He is the forgiven one. يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. Now He will open the doors of the heavens for you. وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. Through istighfar, through repentance, if you turn to Him, He will provide you with children and He will provide you with wealth. He will open the doors of rizq for you. يُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ. You need nice gardens. You need big land. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ. He will give you gardens in this life. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. He will give you fountains and rivers. But you will not get it through these sins and through this obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the rule. The effect of the sin, it brings darkness in our heart. It just takes away the nur of iman. The person does not enjoy his deen anymore. The person does not enjoy anything related to deen. We don't enjoy having our masajid. We don't enjoy the Quran. We don't enjoy the remembrance of Allah. In fact, the person starts enjoying everything haram. This is the effect of sin. Disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the person away from the masajid, threw him in the clubs, took the person away from Quran, made him just sit in front of the haram day and night, watching haram, seeing haram, kept him away from listening to anything good, listening to the haq, doesn't want to hear the advice from parents, from teachers, from relatives, from elders. No one is elder for him anymore. Doesn't want to accept no advice in his life. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Quran, فَذَكِّرْ فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين. Remind, for reminder helps the people of Iman. This person have extinguished the nur of Iman, does not benefit from advisors anymore. He can listen to lectures after lectures, doesn't benefit from it. Nothing helps him, nothing changes his life. He hears the ayahs of Al-Quran, ayah after ayah, hadith after hadith, nothing helps the person. Because he continues committing the sin, he's not ready to give up the sins. These sins are extremely destructive. They destroy our iman. And not only they destroy our iman, they even destroy everything in this life for us. A person who is struggling day and night just for his living, he was supposed to get all of that in few hours, but now he has to spend 8 hours, 10 hours, 16 hours sometimes a day just to get the same risk that he could have got in 2-3 hours. The barakah of the risk is gone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made everything difficult for him now. وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى. As far as those who try to hold everything to themselves, وَاسْتَغْنَى, consider themselves to be very independent. I don't need anything. I don't need masjid. I don't need Quran. I don't need salah. I don't need deen. I don't need to learn deen. وَاسْتَغْنَى, he considered himself to be very independent. فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. We will guide him to the path of difficulties. He will start stopping towards the path of difficulties, difficulty after difficulty in his life. Problems after problem will keep on coming up in his life. He thinks, I'm independent. I can do this, I can do that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. If Allah makes it difficult, who can make it easy then? That's it. This person is just heading towards difficulties in his life and he's not coming towards an ease. أَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى. Those who like to give, وَاتَّقَى, and they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى, they confirm the good words that Allah has revealed. فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى. We will make the path of ease easy for them. So they come towards the direction that is easy for them in life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps on making things easy for them. So the sin, the effect of the sins is that they take away the tawfiq. They take away the tawfiq of the amal al-salihah, of good deeds from us. The person doesn't get tawfiq to do anything good anymore. Doors of good are open. Doors of the masajid are open. The person has time to read Quran. No, but he doesn't want to do it. When we complain that I don't have time to do any, even 2 extra rak'ahs in my life, it's not because we don't have the time. Just try to sit and make a schedule of your daily life and see how much time we spend for things that we really didn't even need and we didn't benefit from. All of that time was wasted because there is no barakah in our time. It's the disobedience of Allah that took the tawfiq of the good deeds away from us. Now the person doesn't even come towards the good deeds. Not only this, unfortunately, sometimes we see people even come to the masajid, but even after coming to the masjid, the tawfiq of amal al-salih, of good deed, is not there anymore, and doesn't even pray. Sometimes, to the extent, people don't even pray the salah in the masajid, and they were in the masjid at the time of adhan. Tawfiq of the good deed is taken away. Effect of sins. Day and night, disobeying Allah. Allah says, okay, I'll keep you away too. I don't need you. You think you are independent? وَاللَّهُ الْغَنِيُّ وَأَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ. Allah is independent. You need Allah. But he behaves as if he doesn't need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If deen needs me, then come and call me. And then I will see if I have time or not. If deen needs me, if masajid need me, if Islam needs me, then tell me what Islam needs and then I will look into it. وَاسْتَغْنَى, considers himself to be very independent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, okay, keep on going on. He takes the tawfiq of amal al-salihah away from the person. And then the effect of that is, the person doesn't like anything that is related to deen. It starts loving everything that is away from deen. Now, you see the person enjoying the clubs, enjoying the songs, doesn't enjoy listening to Quran no more. Yes, enjoys the music, but doesn't enjoy Quran anymore. Doesn't enjoy the good words of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam anymore. The most attractive thing to this person is when this person is listening to music, he can spend day and night. He can spend 3 hours easy in front of the TV watching that movie. He was not satisfied with that small TV. He got a big theater in his house. The whole basement is a theater now. For what? For the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah gave him the mal. Allah gave him the rizq from halal. He wanted to bring all the haram into his house now. This is the effect of the sins. When the person starts sinning outside, he was not satisfied. He brought all the means of sins inside his house now. Now his wife and his children, women who are staying home, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected them from all the haram, but the man brings all the haram into the house, and now this woman sitting in the house without having to go outside, she is seeing all the dancing and singing and drinking, everything on the screen in front of her in the house. This is the effect of our sins. Because of the sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes the amal as-salih away from us. He keeps us away from the good deeds. And gradually the person starts going towards haram. And every step this person takes is towards haram. The effect of the sins, that the person does not get along with anyone. No one likes him, he doesn't like anyone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that in Quran, قُلْ هُوَ الْقَادِرُ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابًا مِّنْ فَوْقِكُمْ أَوْ مِّنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِكُمْ أَوْ يَلْبِسَكُمْ شِيعًا وَيُذِيقَ بَعْضَكُمْ بَأْسَ بَعْضٍ. He has the power that he would send a punishment from above you or from underneath you. He says, don't think that you can hide in the house and skip the punishment of Allah. عَذَابًا مِّنْ فَوْقِكُمْ. He can send the punishment from above. He can send the punishment from underneath. أَوْ يَلْبِسَكُمْ شِيعًا. Or he would divide you into small groups. وَيُذِيقَ بَعْضَكُمْ بَأْسَ بَعْضٍ. And he will show each other the strengths of other. Which means, every person will be using his energy just to destroy the other Muslims and just to hurt the other people of Iman. This is where our energy will be used. يُذِيقَ بَعْضَكُمْ بَأْسَ بَعْضٍ. This is all different type of punishment. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu says, in the tafsir of this ayah, يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابًا مِّنْ فَوْقِكُمْ. Allah will send punishment from above you and from underneath you. He says, as much as this refers to the natural calamities, at the same time it refers to from above you, anyone who's above you will not take care of you, will not fulfill his responsibility towards you. And from underneath you means that anyone that is under you will not obey you and will not do the things that will please you. So a person is always in difficulty. The people who are above him, they don't take care of him. People under him, they don't obey him. This is the effect of the sins. One of the scholars of the Tabi' Tabi'een, he got on his right. As he got on his horse, the horse started jumping. Right away he came down, started doing istighfar. He says, this is the effect of my sin, that the punishment is coming from underneath me, that now today my horse is disobeying me. Imam Ibn Sirin rahimahullah, he used to do business selling oil. He used to sell oil. Once, he lost in his business $40,000. And that was the money that he borrowed from someone. That person went and complained. Long story short, Imam Ibn Sirin, Muhammad Ibn Sirin, well-known scholar of Islam, one of the great tabi'een, ended up being behind the bars in the prison. At that time, when his students went to visit him, he said, "Inni a'lamu min ayna utit." I know where this punishment came to me from. I know why I'm in this situation. He says, about 40 years ago, when I was a young man, once I saw a person, a very poor man on the street. And I said to someone, I said, look at this person who's bankrupt. This person is bankrupt. He said, because I said that one word to this person, today I'm in that position and I have been put in this situation. Scholars commenting on his statement, they say that those people, those were the people who may have committed one or two sins in their lives, so they knew where this difficulty is coming from. But because we have so many sins, we don't even realize that whatever we are going through is the effect of our sins. 40 years back, as a young man, he says about a person that he's a bankrupt. 40 years later, he sees the effect of it in his life. Making fun of a poor man, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like it. Just see the things we have been doing day and night in our lives. Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah, very sharp, very intelligent. When he was memorizing the Quran, he used to keep a blank page on one side so that he doesn't look at it. And otherwise, he would memorize that side before the first side. Now, as he is studying the hadith, those were the a'imma who wanted to memorize all the knowledge of Quran and hadith, the meaning of Quran and hadith. So he went and complained to his teacher, Waqi' ibn al-Jarrah. Waqi' ibn al-Jarrah is a well-known muhaddith of Islam, teacher of Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah, who wrote 40,000 ahadith with his own hands. He wrote 40,000 ahadith. Imam Shafi'i says, and he put it in a poem, Shakawtu ila waqi'in su'a hifzi. I complained to my teacher Waqi' about not having a good memory. Who's complaining? Imam Shafi'i is complaining about his memory. My memory is not that good. And his memory is that, you can say the photographic memory. He just looks at the page and he memorizes it. This is why he has to keep a blank page on the other side. Yet, shakawtu ila waqi'in su'a hifzi. I complained to my teacher Waqi' about not having a good memory. Farshadani ila tarkil ma'asi. He said to me, you have make sure you refrain from sins. He didn't say, no, you're doing good. Arshadani ila tarkil ma'asi. He said to me, look at yourself and see if you have been doing anything wrong. وَقَالَ إِنَّ الْعِلْمَ نُورٌ مِّنْ إِلَٰهٍ. He said to me, this ilm of deen is a nur from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنُورُ اللَّهِ لَا يُعْطَى لِعَاصِي. The nur of Allah will not be given to a sinner. You cannot have the zulumat, the darknesses of sins, and then try to put the nur of the ilm of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. So effect of the sin, it keeps us away from learning deen, from having the understanding of deen. It takes away the understanding of deen away from us. This is the effect of sins, that the person doesn't learn deen no more, doesn't want to learn it. We feel, I don't have time. It's not that I don't have time, it's the sins that are keeping us away from it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Quran repeatedly about the previous nations, that those nations came with all kind of strength and power, all kind of abilities. Different nations showed different abilities. Just imagine, Fir'aun with his kingdom, such a powerful kingdom that he was able to convince people that he is God, wal'ayyazu billah, and people were worshipping him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I destroyed him and all of his army, all of his people. I destroyed Fir'aun with the whole army. What destroyed Fir'aun and his army? It was nothing but disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he decided that he would continue disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's not ready to change. He's not ready to come towards the obedience of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed him. The nation of Thamud, very strong nation. They built their castles out of mountains. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. The nation of Ad, very intelligent nation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them a lot of abilities using their intelligence. But when they decided to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the whole nation. The people of Shu'aib alayhi salam, some of the best business people the world have seen. And they were controlling the whole business of the world at that time, the people of Shu'aib. But they used to cheat people. When they decided to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah destroyed them. It's the sins that have been destroying nation after nation. Nation after nation was destroyed. It was the effect of their sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Quran, فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ. I'm not saying it. Rabbul Alameen is telling us, what destroyed those nations? فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ. We destroyed all of them because of their sins. بِذَنْبِهِ. because of their sins. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ حَاصِبًا. Some of them, we sent the stones, we throw the stones on them, just like the people of Lut عليه الصلاة والسلام. The whole city was turned over and the stones were thrown on them. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَخَذَتْهُ الصَّيْحَةِ. Some of them were destroyed by a blast of a sound. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضِ. Some of them were swallowed by the earth. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَغْرَقْنَا. And some of them we have drawn in the water, and that is بِذَنْبِ. All of them because of their sins. Then there is nothing more destructive in this world than sins. It's not the weapons. It's not anything else. It's the sins of human beings. My sin and your sin. It's our sins. If we stop disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take this destruction away from us. The thing that is bringing the destruction is this, is the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِ. We got all of them because of their sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us the rule. أَلَمْ نُهْلِكِ الْأَوَّلِينَ. Didn't we destroy the people before you? ثُمَّ نُتْبِعُهُمُ الْآخِرِينَ. And then there were nations after them. We destroyed them one after another. كَذَلِكَ نَفْعَلُ بِالْمُجْرِمِينَ. This is what we would do to the wrongdoers now too. This is what we would do to the wrongdoers now too. Imam Yafi'i rahimahullah, one of the very well-known scholars of Islam, have narrated an incident. A young man who used to deliver things to people's homes, this was his job, delivery. Once he went to a place for some delivery, and right there he was approached by a woman, a young beautiful girl who's inviting him towards the sin. Now he realized that he's stuck and he cannot run away. She had some people to help her, workers who had locked the doors as he went in the house for delivery. This person said, sure, I like to do that too, but I need to use the bathroom. He went into the bathroom. This young man went into the bathroom, and as he was in the bathroom, he took all the mess in the bathroom and put it all over his body. As he came out, the girl looked at him. She doesn't even want to stand next to him. He has all the dirt on his body, on his face, on his hands, on his feet. There is all najasa, there is dirt. This is what he did from the bathroom. He took all of that, put it on himself. That was to save himself from disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He came out. Of course, she forced them to leave. She said to his people that this is insane. This person doesn't know what he's doing. So they let him out. That person went back home. He took a shower. Nighttime, he sees a dream that someone is telling him that as you have put that najasa on yourself just to protect yourself from disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now we will give you a fragrance instead of that najasa. And like an angel applied some fragrance on his body. Imam Yafi rahimahullah says, we all witness for that this young man throughout his life, he used to have a beautiful fragrance from his body, a fragrance that no one ever had in his life and no one ever smelled. And he always used to have it at all times because of the barakah of that dream and protecting himself from sin. The effect is there. For doing good, there is a good effect. For bad, there is a bad effect. All of those nations, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the example of those nations so that we realize that, you know, for those sins, if they were punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rule of Allah is same. The rule of Allah didn't change. And those rules will apply again and again. كَذَلِكَ نَفْعَلُ بِالْمُجْرِمِينَ. This is what we would do to the wrongdoers again. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and give us tawfiq to refrain from sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to always stay away from all kind of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, it's the plan, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls everything. In future sessions, we will talk about the stories of those anbiya alayhimu salatu wassalam and their nations, to see what mistakes those nations have made because of which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed those nations so that we don't repeat those type of mistakes in our lives. And at least it will be a lesson for us that Allah is teaching us in Quran. It will be a lesson for us how to protect ourselves from the ghadab of Allah, from the wrath of Allah, from the anger of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.
يظلم الظالم حتى يموت المظلوم ألما وجوعا وبكاء، ثم يظن الظالم أن ظلمه مات وانتهى بموت المظلوم؟ لا، يظن الظالم أنه يعيش آمنا مطمئنا؟ لا وبالطبع لا، إن الظلم ظلمات يوم القيامة، ولا بد وأن تكون ردود فعل لما فعل هذا الظالم. وأسوأ شيء يفعله الإنسان في حياته وأفسد شيء له ولمن حوله هي الذنوب والمعاصي، السموم، الغازات، القنابل، كل هذه الأشياء ليست بأفسد من المعاصي، بل هي نتيجة لبعض المعاصي التي نعملها ونقع فيها. وما أصابكم من مصيبة فبما كسبت أيديكم ويعفو عن كثير. فبما كسبت أيديكم ويعفو عن كثير، الكثير منها عفو، عفى الله عنها في هذه الدنيا، يرى الإنسان نتيجتها في قبره وفي الآخرة. وفي هذه الدنيا إنما يرى نتيجة بعض أعماله. من آثار الذنوب والمعاصي ظلمة في القلب وحرمان الطاعة. يحرم الإنسان نور الإيمان، يحرم لذة الإيمان، يحرم حلاوة الإيمان، فلا يجد في عبادته حلاوة، يصلي وليس لصلاته أي حلاوة، يذكر الله وليس في ذكره أي حلاوة، يتلو كتاب الله وليس له أي حلاوة، لا يجد طعم أي شيء من أطعمة الإيمان. ومن آثار الذنوب سلب التوفيق للطاعات، يسلب الله سبحانه جل وعلا من هذا الشخص توفيق الطاعات، فلا يوفق لأمور الخير، مع أن أبوابها مفتوحة، وكثير من أهله وزملائه في أمور الخير، لكن هو لا يوفق لأمور الخير لأجل معاصيه، لأنه عصى ربه سبحانه جل وعلا وأغضب إله العالمين سبحانه جل وعلا. ومن آثار الذنوب والمعاصي عدم الاتعاظ بالمواعظ، وعدم الالتفات إلى النصيحة ولو كانت من أب شفيق وأم حنون، لكنه لا يوجد بدليل. هذه من آثار المعاصي ومن آثار عصيان الله سبحانه جل وعلا وغضب الله سبحانه جل وعلا على عبده. ومن آثار المعاصي أن الإنسان يستأنس بغير الله ويستوحش بالله سبحانه جل وعلا، فإذا جلس وحيدا فريدا لذكر الله ولعبادته يستوحش ويستأنس بغير الله سبحانه جل وعلا، يجلس وحيدا أمام التلفاز، لكنه يجلس ساعات، وإذا جلس وحيدا في المساجد أو على المصلى يقرأ كتاب الله سبحانه جل وعلا يستوحش، لا يستأنس بالله ولا بكتابه ولا بذكره ولا بعبادته سبحانه جل وعلا، كما قال الله جل وعلا: وإذا ذكر الله وحده اشمأزت قلوب الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة وإذا ذكر الذين من دونه إذا هم يستبشرون. يستبشر بكل أشياء الدنيا، بكل أمور الدنيا، بكل علوم من علوم الدنيا، لكنه لا يستبشر بعلم الله سبحانه جل وعلا ولا بكتاب الله جل وعلا. ومن آثار المعاصي أن الإنسان يجد وحشة مع أهل الدين والصلحاء ويستأنس بالفساق والفجار، أماكن الفسق والفجور يستأنس فيها، ومساجد الله سبحانه جل وعلا يستوحش بها ويهرب عنها. ومن آثار المعاصي على حياة العبد حرمان الرزق الحلال، أن الله سبحانه جل وعلا يحرمه من الحلال، كما قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن العبد ليحرم الرزق بالذنب يصيبه. ولقد أخذنا آل فرعون بالسنين ونقص من الثمرات لعلهم يذكرون. أخذنا آل فرعون بالسنين ونقص من الثمرات لعلهم يذكرون، أي حرموا رزق الحلال، فإذا جاءتهم الحسنة قالوا لنا هذا، بأعمالنا أخذنا هذا، بشهاداتي، بعملي، بنتيجة عملي وتجارتي، فإذا جاءتهم الحسنة قالوا لنا هذا، وإن تصبهم سيئة يطيروا بموسى ومن معه، ألا إنما طائرهم عند الله ولكن أكثرهم لا يعلمون. وقالوا مهما تأتنا به من آية لتسحرنا بها فما نحن لك بمؤمنين فارسلنا عليهم الطوفان. آثار الذنوب، تذكروا آثار الذنوب. فارسلنا عليهم الطوفان والجراد والقمل والضفادع والدم، آيات مفصلات، فاستكبروا وكانوا قوما مجرمين. هذه كلها آثار الذنوب والمعاصي. ومن آثار الذنوب أن الله سبحانه جل وعلا أهلك أمما سالفة كثيرة، أمما، بل ونرى في وقت ما أهلك الله سبحانه جل وعلا جميع أهل الأرض ومن فيها إلا الذين نجوا مع نوح في سفينته. لم ينج أحد من أهل الأرض أثر الذنوب والمعاصي. أهلك الله من في الأرض جميعا إلا الذين كانوا مع نوح، وحتى ابنه لما رفض أهلكه الله وأغرقه بعذابه. ابن النبي رفض أن يركب مع نوح عليه السلام، أغرقه الله مع من أغرق. آثار الذنوب والمعاصي. فعلينا عباد الله أن نرتدع عن هذه الذنوب وعن معاصي عن عصيان الله سبحانه جل وعلا. فكل معصية من معاصي الله سبحانه جل وعلا لا بد وأن تجلب مصيبة في هذه الدنيا وفي الآخرة. هذه آثارها. والله جل وعلا يقول عن الأمم السالفة: فكلا أخذنا بذنبه، فمنهم من أرسلنا عليه حاصبا، ومنهم من أخذته الصيحة، ومنهم من خسفنا به الأرض، ومنهم من أغرقنا، وما كان الله ليظلمهم ولكن كانوا أنفسهم يظلمون. ظلموا أنفسهم بعصيان الله سبحانه جل وعلا، ظلموا أنفسهم بعدم اتباع الأنبياء عليهم الصلاة والسلام الذين جاءوهم بشرائع الله سبحانه جل وعلا وبالهداية من الله سبحانه جل وعلا. لما رفضوها فكلا أخذنا بذنبهم، أخذناهم بذنوبهم، وما كان الله ليظلمهم ولكن كانوا أنفسهم يظلمون. فلنرتدع عباد الله. وفي نحن في زمان نرى أن الفواحش والمنكرات والذنوب والمعاصي قد عمت وشعت في كل مكان، لا يلتفت الإنسان يمينا ولا شمالا إلا ويرى ذنبا من الذنوب، يرى ناسا على معصية. الشباب وقعوا في المخدرات، وقعوا في المسكرات، وقعوا في محرمات، وقعوا في كبائر. لعن الذين كفروا من بني إسرائيل على لسان داود وعيسى بن مريم، ذلك بما عصوا وكانوا يعتدون، كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلوه. ذلك بما عصوا وكانوا يعتدون، كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلوه، لبئس ما كانوا يفعلون. ترى كثيرا منهم يتولون الذين كفروا. أثر المعصية كما قلنا أن الإنسان يستوحش بأهل الإيمان ويستأنس بالفساق والفجار. ترى كثيرا منهم يتولون الذين كفروا، لبئس ما قدمت لهم أنفسهم أن سخط الله عليهم وفي العذاب هم خالدون. ولو كانوا يؤمنون بالله والنبي وما أنزل إليه ما اتخذوه أولياء ولكن كثيرا منهم فاسقون. تراهم على الفسق والفجور، تراهم على المعاصي والفواحش والمنكرات. علينا عباد الله أن نبتدع عن هذه المعاصي ونرجع إلى طاعة الله سبحانه جل وعلا وهدي النبي المصطفى عليه الصلاة والسلام. فإن الخير كل الخير في اتباع هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقبول الرشد والهداية الذي نزلت من الله سبحانه جل وعلا. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم، ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم. أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين. الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد فعباد الله، اتقوا الله جل وعلا، راقبوه في السر والعلانية، واعلموا أنكم معروضون على أعمالكم، فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يرى، ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يرى. واعلم عباد الله أن الله أمر بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه، وثنى بملائكته، وثلث بكم أيها المؤمنون، فقال جل وعلا: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ونبينا محمد، وارض اللهم عن جميع أصحاب نبيك أجمعين، وعن الخلفاء الراشدين، وعن بقية الستة من العشرة المبشرة، وعن أهل بيت نبيك أجمعين، وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم بفضلك وجودك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعزنا ولا تذلنا، اللهم أعزنا ولا تذلنا، اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا ويسر الهدى لنا، ربنا افرغ علينا صبرا وتوفنا مسلمين، اللهم لا تقتلنا بغضبك، ولا تهلكنا بعذابك، اللهم لا تهلكنا بعذابك، اللهم انا خلق من خلقك، فلا تمنع عنا بذنوبنا فضلك، ربنا افرغ علينا صبرا وتوفنا مسلمين، ربنا لا تؤاخذنا ان نسينا واخطانا، ربنا ولا تحمل علينا اسما كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا، ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقه لنا به، واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا، انت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. عباد الله رحمكم الله، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي